गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। So we are already discussing in unit 1 introduction to cellular communication system and performance criteria of cellular communication system and uniqueness of mobile radio communication system, operation of cellular system, hexagonal shaped cells, analog systems and digital system. These are the different concepts in your first unit. We are already discussing these topics. So I'm once again repeating this overall first unit now. So why cellular mobile telephone systems? So before the cellular mobile telephone systems, we are having another mobile telephone system that is called as MTS, mobile telephone service, or IMTS, improved mobile telephone service, like that. So in that conventional mobile telephone systems, there are some limitations. Limitations means there are some drawbacks. So these are first one, limited service capability, poor service performance, and inefficient spectrum utilization. Coming to the limited service capability, generally the conventional mobile telephone system, that is previously we are using some MTS telephone system, that is designed by selecting only one or more channels from a specific frequency allocation. That is used to selecting only one or more channels from a specific frequency allocation for use of atomic geographic locations. So the communication area of each zone is normally planned to be as large as possible. So this means the transmit power must be high. So in previous telephone systems, that is designed by selecting only one or more channels from specific frequency allocation for the use of atomic geographic locations, right? And also in conventional telephone systems, the user who starts a call in one zone has to reinitiate the call when he is moving from one zone to another zone, because the call will be dropped. So this is the major problem in conventional mobile telephone systems, since there is no guarantee when the call can be completed without handoff capability. So here the handoff is a process of automatically changing the frequency when the mobile unit is moving from one place to the another place. So this is limited service capability. In the diagram, we are already the two circuits represents two geographic locations, and F1 is one base station and another F2 is another base station. So it is represented by F1 is represented base station or cell site. So in the first circle, this is the first circle F1. In this circle, these are your mobile units. They are served by using F1. And second circle, this mobile unit is serving by another cell site F2. When this mobile unit is moving from, particularly this mobile unit is moving from this service area or this geographic location to this geographic location, he has to reinitiate the call. Automatically the call will be dropped here, because of the serving cell site for two zones is different here. Serving cell site for two zones is different here. So this is your first cell site and this is your
second cell side. So automatically the call is called to be dropped here. So this is the problem in conventional mobile telephone system. So in present scenario, we are having handoff technology. Handoff means automatically changing the frequency when that mobile unit is moving from this particular mobile unit is moving from this geographic location to this geographic location. So call need not to be reinitiated and automatically the frequency were changed. The base station were changed here. So this is our first drawback. And second one is poor service performance. In poor service performance means in previous communication system, we're having 33 channels. These 33 channels are allotted to three mobile telephone systems. That is MTS and IMTS and IMTS MJ systems and MK systems. We're having 33 channels. These 33 channels are allotted to MTS and IMTS MJ systems and IMTS MK systems. In this, the MTS operate around 40 MHz and also MJ operate at 150 MHz and these both provide 11 channels and IMTS MK operates at 450 MHz and provide 12 channels. For example, in New York City had 6 channels of MJ system serving 320 customers with another 2,400 customers are in waiting list. New York City also 6 channels of MK system serving only 225 customers with another 1,300 customers are in waiting list. The large number of subscribers created high blocking probability during the busy hours. So this is about your poor service performance. The large number of subscribers are increased, the blocking probability is also increasing busy hours. So the capacity of the cellular system must be increased. Next one is inefficient spectrum, frequency spectrum utilization. The conventional system does not utilize this spectrum efficiently since each channel can only serve one customer at a time in a whole area. That means in conventional telephone systems, if we are having 10 channels, it can able to serve only for 10 customers only. It can able to service only 10 customers. But in present scenario, if we are having 10 channels, we are having some different techniques like frequency reuse, and also we are having cell splitting like that. By using this frequency reuse, we can serve more number of users rather than 10. We were able to serve more number of users using frequency reuse or cell splitting. But in previous communication system, the frequency spectrum cannot be utilized properly. So the system is having only limited users and limited number of channels. So the major approaches to achieve the ideal are, that means there are some spectral efficiency considerations here. Spectrum efficiency considerations. Single sideband, which divides the allotted frequency into maximum number of channels. We already know that SSB in our analog communication. Single sideband system, which divides the allotted frequency band into maximum number of channels. And also, just now I'm discussing cellular, which reuses the allotted frequency band in different geographic locations. That is frequency reuse. Frequency reuse means the frequency can be reusable with a different geographic location, not in the same geographic location, but it can be used in the different geographic locations. and third one is spectrum or frequency coupled, which generate many codes over the wideband frequency, that is CDMA. Spectrum or frequency coupled means, which is a multiple access techniques, which is the one of the multiple access techniques, which generate many codes over a wide frequency band. Here the in frequency coupled spectrum, the users are differentiated by codes. Each user is having unique code and they are separated by using codes only. And the frequency hopping means frequency is continuously changing for different users, continuously changing. And this frequency hopping technology, the data security is also very high. Next, this is our basic cellular system. Basic cellular system means, here the major elements are only three, that is cell site, MTSO, cell site, mobile unit, and MTSO. We are already know that what is a mobile unit and what is a cell site. Cell site means just having a tower that is used to transmitting and receiving the signals. That means that is having some antennas to transmit and that is some having some antennas to receive data from other services like MTSO or land telephone network. And also cell site is having some Wi-Fi links and some of the data links which are connected to the MTSO mobile telephone switching office. MTSO is the part of your telephone cellular communication system, and all the landline networks are connected to this MTSO. And also each and every tower, that means each and every cell site, is connected to the MTSO using some trunking lines, that means some voice or data links. And also, we already know that what is a mobile unit. A mobile telephone unit contains a control unit and a transmitter and a receiver. We know that we are having everyone having a mobile units, mobiles. So in that mobile, we are having some antennas that is used for transmitting and receiving antennas. Next one is cell site. Cell site provides interface between MTSO and mobile unit. MTSO and mobile unit. And it has a control unit, radio cabinets, antennas, and power plant, and radio terminals. And third one is MTSO. MTSO is the switching office, the central coordinating unit for all cell sites, containing a cellular processor, cellular switch, and it interfaces with telephone company zone offices, controls call processing and call handling and call billing activities. So I already told that MTSO is the heart of the cellular mobile communication system. And each and every process could be done by MTSO, from beginning from the call processing up to billing activities. And fourth one is, there are some connections as there, radio and high speed data links connected to the three sub systems. Each mobile unit can only use one channel at a time for its communication link. And coming to the operation of our cellular system, mobile unit initialization means mobile unit itself originated a call. That means mobile unit can able to search a frequency, and that should be connected to the frequency itself. That is mobile unit initialization. And also mobile originated call. Here a request for a service is sent on selected setup channel, is obtained from self location scheme. And also next, network originated call. Network originated call means a landline part dials a mobile number. That comes under the network originated call. And also we know that call termination procedure and also handoff procedure. So this is your operation of cellular mobile system. The performance criteria of cellular mobile system can be described by three terms here. One is coverage, required grade of service, and also number of dropped calls here. So here the performance criteria of a cellular system can be described by using a voice quality and also a set of value X at which the Y percentage of customers rate the system voice quality from transmitter and to receiver as good or excellent. The top two circuits are listed below. So these are some circuits. CM5 means excellent, CM4 means good, CM3 means fair. So here the service quality can be achieved by following considerations: coverage area, required grade of service, number of dropped calls. So here the system should have to serve as large as possible. That means the service area of system must be, service area must be large. The large area means it requires more number of transmitted power, and also the transmitted power would have been very high to eliminate the weak spots, sufficient reception, a significant added cost factor. So if the transmitter power need to be increased, it means the cost of the system is also increasing. The higher the transmitted power, the harder it becomes to be control interface. Also, number of dropped calls. Number of dropped calls means a high drop rate. That means a high drop rate could be caused by either coverage problems or handoff problems. Either coverage or handoff problems. The coverage problems can be avoided by using the by increasing the power of the transmitted, but the cost should be high. And we know that these are the special features of the mobile telephone system. So we already know that in our mobile phones we are having these features like call forwarding, call waiting, and VSR, voice storage box, automatic roaming, navigation services. So for these different features we need not to pay any extra cost. These are the basic features. And next, uniqueness of our mobile radio environment. Uniqueness of mobile radio environment means, so in the figure we are observing an antenna located at a height of 3200 meters. And a mobile unit is travel at a distance of 2 kilometers from the antenna, and there is two paths from transmitted to the receiver. So the mobile unit either be transmitted or either be received. Okay, from the antenna to the mobile unit, there are different paths. That means the signal can be reached to the mobile unit by using a direct path. Direct path is called as a line of sight path or a reflected path from the ground. So these are two possibilities here. The elevation angle of direct path is theta 1, and the elevation angle of direct path 2 is theta 2. So the propagation path loss would be 40 dB per decade. So this means that 40 dB loss is the signal receiver will be observed by mobile unit as it move from 1 to 10 kilometers. So I am telling that there is a loss of 40 dB. The loss could be identified by up to 10 kilometers, it would be 40 dB. This is general. In general case, the 40 dB loss is assumed by when the mobile unit moving from 1 to 10 kilometers. When C is the received carrier power, R is the distance measured from transmitter to receiver, and having some formula here, the difference in power reception two different distances, R1 and R2, will be resulted C2 by C1 is equal to R2 by R1 whole power minus 4. The decibel expression is delta C in decibels is equal to C2 minus C1. That is equal to 10 log C2 by C1 is equal to 40 log R1 by R2. Fading signal is received while the mobile unit is moving. Fading means fluctuations in signal amplitude. While the mobile unit is moving, the received signal can be like that. In the figure, we are observing that there is an amplitude level of 63. The fluctuations of amplitude from 1 to approximately 93 or 99. So that is called a fading signal. How the fading signal is fluctuations in signal amplitude. How the fluctuations are coming when mobile unit is moving from one place to the another place. Next, service fading. Because of height of antenna, the mobile unit is lower than a typical surroundings, and the carrier frequency wavelength is much less than the size of the surrounding structures. Multipath waves are generated. At the mobile unit, the sum of multipath waves causes signal fading phenomenon. Next, long-term fading. Long-term fading occurs when the propagation of environments, the propagation environment is changing significantly, but this fading is typically much slower than short-term fading. Long-term fading occurs when the propagation environment is changing significantly, but this fading is typically much slower than short-term fading. What is long-term fading? Long-term fading means slower variations in mean signal strength and is produced by movement over much long distances. So in previous picture, we are observing is there is a fading there. Long-term fading means the variations, the amplitude variation here, the amplitude variations are here. These variations are much slower. Slower means the distance is increasing. And long-term fading is caused by terrain configuration like hill and flat area, which results in local mean attenuation fluctuations. Long-term fading is called as slow fading or shadowing. So what is direct wave, what is line of sight, and obstructive path? A direct wave path is a path clear from terrain, the counter. And the line of sight path is path clear from buildings. In the mobile radio environment, we don't have always have a line of sight condition. Mobile radio environment, we do not have always a line of sight condition. When a terrain counter blocks the direct path, we call it as obstructive path. Mobile fading characteristics. Here, mobile fading characteristics means, let us observe here, there is an antenna is propagating a signal, and the mobile unit is located inside the different buildings. So the signal coming from the signal coming from the buildings The signal is coming in from the buildings. In the multi-part waves bouncing back and forth due to the building and houses, they form many standing wave pairs in the space. Those standing wave pairs are assumed together to become an irregular wave fading structure. So when the mobile antenna is standing, still it's received a signal strength at a spot. So constant signal is observed. So when mobile unit is standing still, its receiver only receives a signal strength at the spot. So the constant signal is observed. When the mobile unit is moving, fading structures of the wave in the space is increased. Next, what is delay spectrum? In mobile radio environment, the result of multipath reflection phenomenon, the signal transmitted from a cell site and the receiving at the mobile unit will be found different paths. And since each path have different path length, the time of arrival of each path is also different. For an impulse transmitted at the cell site, by the time this impulse is received at the mobile unit by no longer in impulse, but rather than pulse which is spread with the time of impulse is received at the mobile unit is no longer an impulse, but rather than pulse with a spread width that we call the delay spread. The measured data indicate the mean delay spread at different kinds of environment. And next, what is coherent bandwidth? So in coherent bandwidth is defined bandwidth in which either the amplitudes or phases of two received signals having higher degree of similarity. The delay spread is a natural phenomenon, and the coherent bandwidth is defined creation related to the delay spread. So coherent bandwidth BC is equal to, we can write as 1 by 2 pi delta or 1 by 4 pi delta. In some cases should be different, like BC is equal to 1 by 50 delta sigma t, and BC is approximately equal to 1 by 5 delta pi sigma t. And this is already we are discussing operation of signal systems. And next, hexagonal shaped shields. Hexagonal cell shapes are artificial, and the shape cannot be generated in the real world. You cannot generate it in the hexagonal shape in the real world. Just the engineers draw hexagonal shaped cells on layout to simply and planning the design of a cellular system. The cellular shapes having overlapped antennas, overlapped areas, which make the drawing unclear, so the hexagonal shaped cells fit the planned area nicely. So here we are observing that in the three pictures, one picture is the hexagonal shaped cells. In hexagonal shaped cells, it covers entire area. There is no overlaps and there is no empty areas. While we are considering ideal case, that is circular case, there are overlapping areas there. But in the real world, the hexagonal shaped cells are ideal cells are not possible. The real area should be like in this third picture. This is in the reality. We cannot justify the area like this hexagonal shaped cells or like circles. Next, analog cellular systems. There are 150 major market areas in the United States where licenses for cellular systems can be generated by FFC. They can be classified by the different groups. So top 30 markets are very large cities. 31 to 60 markets are large size cities. 61 to 90 markets, medium size cities, and 91 to 120 markets, below medium size cities. And also 121 to 150 cities, small size cities. And coming to the distance in the system, now we know that in our mobile telephone system, we are having GSM, TDMA, CDMA, and PDC, and also 1800 DC. PDC means personal digital cellular. Personal digital cellular. And 1800 DC is digital communication system. We coming to the concept of frequency reuse. Frequency reuse means the same frequency can be reused by different geographic locations. So the frequency reuse is the concept. In the mobile telephone systems, the frequency reuse systems, users are in different geographic locations, but they are used by same frequency, but the locations are different locations. So while they are using in the same location, the interference due to the common use of the same channel is called as co-channel interference. While the frequency reuse concept is used in the same location, the problem occurred is co-channel interference. And our major concern in the concept of frequency reuse. So this is the concept of frequency reuse here. The two cellular cell sites must be kept in a distance of D. The cell site one is described by C1 and also another one is C2. And P0 is our cell site, and the distance from the area is R. So the quality and efficiency of the cellular system can be described by C by AU is equal to gamma. This is our frequency reuse spectrum. The frequency reuse spectrum is used in time domain and the space domain. And the frequency reuse in space domain is divided into two categories. Same frequency is assigned in two geographic locations such as AM and FM stations using the same frequency at different cell sites. And same frequency is repeatedly used in same geographic area in one system. The scheme is called as cellular systems. There are many co-channel cells in the system. The total frequency spectrum allocation is divided into K reuse spectrums. That is K is equal to 4, 7. These are the frequency reuse spectrums in the cell site. Thank you. I'm continuing in next class.